Honey, wow, today we are getting wed. We have waited and hoped for this day for so long. You are truly the most special person on this earth to me, and that is never, ever going to change. I believe that God has brought us together, and He is going to sustain us in our marriage for the rest of our lives. I pray that we can give Him all the glory today, and that we take a few moments to thank Him in our hearts throughout this day. Lord, I ask that the love and bond Robert and I feel for one another would only grow stronger every day for the rest of our lives. I pray that we can be instruments of your peace to one another today and every day. You, Robert, are the only man in the world for me, and the one I have prayed for and hoped for my whole life. I would follow you anywhere. You're my best friend, and I don't deserve you. I love you always, your Dave.
Kristen, happy wedding day. Today is the day we have been working and waiting for with great anticipation for a long time. I can't believe I have the honor of saying I do to forever with you today. No, I haven't cried yet. I'm so excited to begin the journey of a lifetime together with you today. Let's get wed with all my love.
I, Robert, take you, Kristen, to be my wife.
I, Kristen, take you, Robert, to be my husband.
My constant companion.
Loyal partner.
And the love of my life.
I promise before God, our family, and our friends.
To support and care for you in sickness and in health.
In good times and in bad.
In happiness as well as sadness.
I promise to be faithful to you, to honor and respect you. I will never give up on a marriage.
I'll forgive you as we have been forgiven.
Give generously to you and to others.
And strive for a life that reflects Christ's love.
I choose to love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
So much for this amazing day, a day that you have created and blessed, and we are just humbled to be a part of it, that people are here for us, and Lord, we hope that they leave here for you more than when they came. We pray that our marriage would be founded on you, that we would seek Holy Spirit every day, and lay down our lives for each other, and as we partake in this communion. Thank you so much for your sacrifice and sending your son to die for us on the cross. And in that love, we are able to love. There is no greater love than to lay down one's life for his friends, and that's what you did. You call us all friends, and now we can love each other and those around us. And I pray that you help us to do that every day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Stronger together. Lord, just we just bring ourselves to you right now. We ask that you cleanse our hearts of any impurities and fill us with newness as we start a life together, not as two people, but as one person. And we just want to be a spirit-filled marriage and life together. And we pray for our future children that we would be good stewards of them, and what a blessing that will be. And just for all the years to come, Lord, that you would be with us and pull us back to you when we turn away. And we love you so much, Lord. Thank you for Robert.
Of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Robert, you may kiss your bride.
Shape both Kristen and Robert into the people they are today.
Robert has really shown me what it looks like to be a mature man of God. The way he pursues things, like the way he pursues his friendships, the way he pursues God, pursued Kristen and their relationship. It's been really a blessing to see.
Kristen's mom, and part of the great fun of it has been all the people that she's brought into our lives. Like many of you, I wouldn't know if it weren't for her. She's brought a lot of great families and friends, and it's been a real joy. And now she's brought in a new family for us.